Today we're going to make the rear axle for the Kite Buggy. What we're going to be using today is a piece of this. It's an inch and a half shed 10 by 48mm OD. And then one of the main problems what a lot of people have is how do we fit the axle, how do we fit the thread inside the axle. I used to have lathed up bosses to go in there out of solid pieces of stainless, but that got very expensive, and so I've come up with a much easier and much cheaper way of doing this. So anyway, I'll get back to you once I've cleaned this up.
I've cleaned up again. We've cleaned all this stainless tube up now, so it's all a nice mirror finish. What we're going to do now is we're going to be making the threaded inserts what go inside here, so we can put our 20mm stainless axles on to fit the wheels on. So I'll show you how we do that now.
Right, there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can either have these little billets of stainless either laser cut with an 18mm hole in the middle, or you can get a piece of solid round bar, chop them off with a saw and drill an 18mm hole in. Personally, I find it much easier to send them to the laser cutters and get them all done properly. At least you know the hole's in the centre and there's no problem like that. And then from this stage, we get the 20mm nut and then we literally weld that over the hole. So we're going to weld it round there, and then once we've done that, we then hold it in a vise, run a tap through there, and that will tap that back edge on there. So I'll get back to you when we've done that. So there we have nice thread all the way through. Don't know if you can see that on there. So we've got approximately, we've got about at least 20mm, probably 25mm of thread.
Okay,
in there. What we're going to do now is, this is now what goes inside there. We're just going to prep all this top edge around here so we can get a nice weld flush with that. Okay, so I'll just show you what we're doing here. We've got our stainless axle on the bench. It's sat on a couple of spaces down there, another one there, and then clamped down. So that's not going to move anywhere. We've wound our stud bar in to the axle thread. And so when you look down there now, everything is in line. And it's also level that way. So we know that the axle now, the axle boss is now, everything is square. Okay, so our part is now in there, it's tacked in four places, so it's not going to go anywhere, and now we're going to weld this up. Right, so these are our axle plates, 200mm across at the bottom, 100mm centres, 10mm holes. 6mm plate, straight from the laser cutters. So what we're going to do now is we're going to clean these up, take all the sharp edges off, make them all nice and smooth and shiny, and makes life a lot easier at the end.
Right,
before we mark these out, we're just going to clean these ends up, tidy them all up a bit, clean them up. That makes the marking out a little bit more accurate because it's been a little
bumps or anything like that on the end. They're going to be polished up yet once we get around to buffing and that, so we'll do that bit then. But there we go, there's the 20mm thread in the end of the
axle. Right, now what we've got to do is mark it out. We know the axle is 1600mm long, so we'll start off by marking 800mm into the centre. Okay, here you can see the plates just lightly tacked on. So what we're going to do now is we're going to add a few more tacks and then we're going to weld these fully up. Okay, it's all welded up now, so what we've got to do now is wait for this to cool now, because what will happen with that amount of weld, there's 400mm of weld on each plate, so it's 800mm altogether on that axle, which is a hell of a lot. That axle now will be bending like not like a banana, but it'll be quite well bent. So what we'll do is we'll let that cool down completely, and then I'll show you how it's
driving. The axle. You can see where the plates are welded, it's pulled the axle that much, it's bent it. And the ends are probably kicking up about 10-15mm either end, just through that piece of weld. So all we've got to do now is straighten it.
Okay, so here we go. So it's a case of, I can't tell you how much to bend it, how much to pressure to put on it, because obviously every weld is different, every piece of stainless is different. It's more about feel. It doesn't need much, but it's more about feel than anything else. So we'll slide this in there. Put these guides on. They're just a piece of 60mm stainless tube, 5mm wall, and that sits nicely on the top there, and it stops these rollers from digging into the stainless, because it will dint.
Alright, if you look down the tube now, it's as straight as we're going to get that, and it's pretty bloody straight, if you ask me. And there's the axle.